if we're not pushing ourselves, if we aren't like tired when we're done studying, then we haven't earned a break. If you don't finish a study session, oh shoot, I worked hard. Something's wrong with your studying.
But stop making excuses, stop whining, stop, right? Get at it. No excuses, just dominate.
Everyone's disability is different. Even the same diagnosis is different for different people and shades. There's a couple ways that we could mix up things. And the most common way is actually not technically a disability. It's a mental health issue. And that a lot of times we overwhelm our brain such that we aren't actually focused on what we're supposed to be holding. So it's a lack of focus. It's not distraction. It's inattention. So we are saying, I want to keep these numbers. I want to hold this. And we aren't skilled at directing focus towards the task at hand. Sometimes for certain people, they can feel like they have, and this is, so when I've done work with students with disability, this is something we work diligently on, and they hate it, is we work on reducing distractibility and maximizing focus and attention holding. And so literally I'll be in a room with them and I'll be hitting them with stuff. And the whole intention is I want you to work through that because yes, you felt that paper hit you in the ear or you helped whatever, keep going. I'll whisper things as they're running through things because I'm forcing their brain to work through my distraction and my numbers to hold their numbers. Does that make sense? It's miserable, especially if you have a learning disability, that like just holding numbers by itself or doing different tasks by itself is difficult enough. I make it darn near impossible. And so it's very strenuous for them and it's very exhausting, but it's a process of building those skills. And even minor gains make big differences for them. That's the way you get to look at your MCAT prep and what you're studying is that oftentimes people are like, okay, yeah, this blah, blah, blah didn't work for me. I wasn't instantly better. And it's not the case for some of us because for some of us, our brains work differently. And any disadvantage, disability can be overcome, but we have to start working differently and we have to recognize the scope and curve of our learning ability and where we're going. And okay, how far am I along my potential greatness? And am I working at that? And like I said, for me, working and developing my brain to a well-oiled machine, I was constantly stressing my brain. I lived in a stress state, always challenging myself, forcing myself, remember this, recall this, think about this, roll this over, all these things, because every moment of my day became a training opportunity. It's like any sort of medical training, law enforcement training, military training. The whole point of these trainings at these highest levels, what they're really trying to do is to get you to operate on autopilot. So that way you, when a stimulus happens, you have a default response. Without even thinking, this is the response. We act in this way at a high level. That's what training is supposed to do. And in academics, you can train yourself in that same way to create default patterns of behavior that become almost mechanistic because we've programmed ourselves to act in such a way. But it actually has to be worked at. It takes a while, but we work at it, we work at it, we work at it, and we improve because we want to push ourselves to that point. And so I developed myself tremendously because I stressed myself. It's why for you guys, when we talk about five pillars, the importance of reading and developing that skill habit, the reason I want you guys to work harder now and stress yourself is because what? I want you to have stretched yourself here this far by the time you actually need it and you're ready to go. That's the point, is we got to understand there's work to be done to get to this point. So when are we going to start doing that work? Not when we need it. Let's start doing it now when we don't need it so we can get to there. So did I answer that question that was off topic, on topic?
It was completely on topic and actually exactly what I needed. The thing is, I don't react to stress the same way as you did probably, Dr. Pinesett. Like you talk about stressing yourself, consistently challenge yourself. Those things work for me in a military setting and just with physical stress. I can push my body to the limit.
So any stressor, this is what the military has learned also, right? The military is a great case. You want to talk about great research writing? Look at some of these research studies that have been conducted on military personnel. They're incredible because they show you in a scientific manner that the military has figured out exactly how to reprogram human beings. It's incredible. And so for you, what we have to understand is any amount of stress is completely tolerable based on either duration or amount. So there's two axes. So you can tolerate any stressor as long as the duration is short enough. When stress becomes overwhelming is when you have a high level of stress at too long of a duration or an interval. So when I talk about every day was a training opportunity, everything was spurts of training, moments of training. It wasn't like I'm sitting here, 10 hours, you will sit here. No, as I'm walking through, there's a clock, this, that, the other thing, blah, blah, blah. As I'm driving over here, okay, listen, I read this earlier today. Okay, it was this, and I flip all the terms around, blah, blah. That was me taking spurts of stressing myself. So if we are attempting to grow, I'm not saying you should study 10 hours a day, but what I'm saying is when we do put in time, we have to push ourselves to get better. If we're not pushing ourselves, if we aren't like tired when we're done studying, then we haven't earned a break. If you don't finish a study session, oh shoot, I worked hard. Something's wrong with your studying. You should need a break. And that's why we reinforce, right? We do take breaks, real breaks. We do get real sleep because we should be working ourselves so hard that we need those things. So for you, Stuart, I'm not saying you go 2 hours. I'm saying, can you give me 30 minutes of your greatest focus and then take an hour off? When we are trying to focus, can we force ourselves to get at it? So can I be going and doing my test, and then after my test, I'm reviewing my test, like in nonchalant mode as I'm reading the description, okay, blah, blah, blah. And then I'm going to force myself to go, wait, how can I remember this? And I'm going to force myself for 5 minutes to sit there and push my brain to the limits of how can I push this deep inside and make it meaningful? Let me just say, like when you're weightlifting, if you're not training to failure, you're not going to get those pumps, baby. We got to get going. Ooh, we got to push that weight. We lift heavy. We lift hard so we can get those pumps. And that's the way we're trying to do with our mental capacity. But a lot of people, and this is the problem with this earth, losers, lazy motherfuckers, is that people aren't willing to work, to be uncomfortable, to be pained, to put in time to grow themselves. They want instant overnight success. And for you guys, hopefully something you've taken from my MCAT course and the structure of it is that when we're talking about getting to that MCAT score of 520 not made overnight, that thing should be hopefully built over 4+ years of your career. Maybe 3 years, maybe 2 years, maybe 1 year, maybe whatever. But we have an understanding of, no, there's a toll that has to be paid to get there. How much of that toll have I already paid? If not, I got to go back and I got to start building up that toll and spending that time. In the same token, I hope that my course has also taught you that it's not always about getting 520. As some of you guys have heard me talking to Spencer's in my TPT program, so I know his whole application and profile and what he's trying to do for medical school. He's got a stellar GPA. He's got the extracurriculars. He's got a nice narrative. He doesn't need to get 520. I just want him in a competitive range above the 50th percentile. Because if he can get there, we can swing his application, put together nicely, and get him into medical school. So for some of you guys, recognize, you know what? I've got a learning disability. You know what? I've got a content disadvantage. I got this finite amount of time. I got family constrictions, whatever it is. Okay, so my score, 520 ain't possible. But what can I push myself to reasonably? And then on the flip side of that, we still have to have that accountability to say, are we actually pushing? Okay, yes, I'm going to let myself off the hook a little bit. But am I actually pushing my fullest potential given my constraints and my life situation? And if we're not, we have to make corrections. And there's quite a, actually, let me say, a couple of you guys who are, we're not retakers, but are repreppers can testify to how many times can you guys look back on that first prep when you thought you were working hard and recognize, dang it, I didn't listen to Dr. Pinesett. I was not consistent. Dang it, I didn't listen to Dr. Pinesett. I did not value the MCAT over everything else. Dang it, I did not get my life in order like Dr. Pinesett told me to do, and it cost you. And for you guys who are new to the prep game, and someone just text messaged me privately and said they were new to the course, if you are new to this prepping, learn from the people who have already been here, who recognize that, dang, if I would have just listened to Dr. Price from the beginning and got consistent and pushed myself and did as many questions as I could, I would have been better off. So take those steps, guys. Build your prep. Build your MCAT life in those orders. Okay, do all the little things that add up to getting you to your fullest potential, whatever that may be, 505, 510, 515, 520, whatever it is, your score.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's it for another episode of the Study Doc Show. Show your love by smashing the like button and commenting in the box below. Today is the day, guys. No more excuses, no more complaining. You're going to take your future into your own hands. You're going to dominate. You're going to be successful. I challenge you. What are you going to do today to make your life better? Get to my website, thestudydoc.com. grab a free ebook, sign up for a free webinar, and if you're really ready to transform, enroll in one of my life-changing courses or coaching programs. You have greatness inside you. Let me show you how to unlock it so you can dominate and make your dreams a reality. No excuses, just dominate.